Hi, welcome. I just would like to present you our ports of call. This is the popular ship simulator and economic simulator game, which we had since about 20 years, starting with the Amiga. So now we start ports of call. That's intro screen. You can switch here anytime between full screen and the window mode. Now let's just load an old game so we get a little bit faster on. Very important here, you see an auto-saved game. Always when you stop the phone and cancel, then it's just automatically saved, you can continue. Let's see, go to New York. That's an example which I have prepared. But before we do that, usually when you start the game, the first thing you do is to go to the ship broker and get your ship. There you have several choices, low-cost ships, pre-owned ships and high-tech. The high-tech you usually can buy only after a while when you played the game. Start with a low-cost ship. That's okay, you can buy two usually with the start money. Of course, I have a ship already, so it's a little bit difficult to buy another one. But here, the pre-owned ships have a better ship condition. You can get some information here on the ship if you want to. And let's go back here to the main menu. You have an office. In the office, you can take a look at your possessions, statistics, for example. You see, I've prepared a little bit. That's not very good. I'll get into bankrupt very quickly with that statistic here. And let's go back and let's start the game with start action. The simulator is running. And now the ship arrived at New York. You can steer it by hand. You can do it in the conventional way using the steering buttons here with full ahead, stop, astern. Or if you like more a gamepad-like control, just press here and you can start here to get control over the ship, and it starts now. Let me crash it here a little bit so we can continue. It takes a little bit until you get there into the destination usually. That ship state here is not very good. That condition will lead into a sinking ship. Usually you have to repair it. But let's see the next step. Oh, we were a little bit slow here, have to pay some fee. And now the best, what you can do first, check at the refuel. Yeah, it's quite okay, but if you want to, you can just refuel here. Anytime you can switch to the smaller screen, and then you have some additional buttons, which are sometimes helpful. You get a help, of course, anytime. Can go to the homepage, but then you leave the game and can continue, of course, with the autosaved feature later on. And let's go back here, switch back to full screen again, and then go to the charter menu. And here you have to select a good freight. Check through what is the current offer, for example. We'll see. Depends. Sometimes you get a very good freight rate, but also a time critical freight. You have to take care to be there in time. We'll see. Get your chemicals, what have we. Let's look for the best. Just take this one, it's okay. We go to load, and the ship starts again. A lot of things can happen on sea. You see, for example, I told you already, because the ship condition was not very good, we should have repaired the ship. In this case, it's just going to the fish. And that's over here for this time. You lose the ship. If you have enough money, you can start again and try, but better you start a new game. Here, if you go back, you can save your game if you want to. In this case, it doesn't make very much sense when it's to the fish. Or you can load an old game, of course, that might a little bit more sense. Let's go back to the old starting position. And if you feel you have enough points, money and ships, just press the high score button. You'll go online, will connect when you have an internet connection, and then you can save your high score into our high score list and compare with other players.